What's up? This is Borda Danel. I'm a foodie person. That is why I'm marking World Food Day. But I don't really know much about food and World Food Day come about with something. That is why I tell you, call somebody that is a foodie expert that will come and teach me. And I think maybe we also can learn one or two things from this person. That's why I call Ibon Food. Ibon Food, what's up?
Hello. It's so good to be here. First of all, it's not Ibom food. It's Ibom soups.
Yeah, Ibom soup. Yes. Okay, that is alright. I know, I think food and soup. Soup is a food. So anyway, so Ibom soup, Abi. So what is this World Food Day? Is it a public holiday or something?
World Food Day is not a public holiday, but it's a day that has been selected or has been picked all over the world to celebrate food. Date is October 16th every year, celebrated all over the world. And what inspired this date is actually the same day that Food and Agriculture Organization of United Nations was founded in 1945. And ever since then, 16th of October has been chosen all over the world to celebrate World Food Day.
See, I didn't even know that it's a Food and Agriculture kind of organization that their own thing is just food. That is really, I would like to join them. So, this year now, they are talking about a theme, like something hungry, something. I don't know, maybe we'll explain it because they are the expert here. They will tell us.
So, the theme of this year's World Food Day is our actions, our futures. And the objective of this year is bring hunger level to 0% by 2030 all over the world. So talking about our actions, our future is what we are doing now will determine if we can accomplish this by 2030.
Wait, that's cool, man. Because honestly, me, I learned like this. I used to eat every 30 minutes. So I don't know. You are now saying that you are going to end our hunger. Like, I don't think you understand. So are you saying that if I eat now, I'm not going to be hungry again or anything until 2030 or something?
That's not what we are saying. Okay, so what we are saying is by 2030, each time you are hungry, there's food to eat. That's the idea. So we're not saying you won't go hungry again, but each time you are hungry, there's food to eat. It's not like you have to stay hungry for so long and then
to eat. Okay, thing is that I believe you because I'm a man of faith. I actually believe everything that you are saying. But let's go assume, like, that maybe I don't believe you now. Like, maybe I don't think maybe it can happen. How do you want to do it? I believe you, I know it's something that you can do. I mean, it's not you. I mean, it's something that you do too. But after that, I think maybe I don't believe you. How do you want to do it?
Well, I am not going to do it alone. You and I will do it. Everybody will do it together. So we are all part of it. Do it. Because it involves you.
Excuse me, please. Let me just understand. I'm just an interviewer in prison. I'm just interviewing you so that you will tell us and I will tell the people. This is what they say you should do. So you don't practice it and you implement what they are saying. They practical. But you are not involving me. No, I'm not part of it. I'm not a food expert. I'm not a part of it. I don't think it means
yes,
food.
It's true.
I'm not there.
All of us.
Me, I'm not there.
You are
the food person. Me, I'm just eating. So maybe you just say how you are going to do it. I will tell them so that you will translate it. Because you are involving me. I'm not a food person. So maybe you just do it without me.
It concerns all of us actually because one of the reasons why we don't have enough food in the world is wastage. So even though you consume food, you don't cook food, you also waste food sometimes. When you have food in your plate and you don't finish everything, you are wasting that food. As a matter of fact, statistics have proven that in places like UK, people go to restaurants and then about 17% of the food in their plate that they paid for, they didn't eat. So that's wastage. So if you and I can cut down on wastage, we'll be helping to achieve this goal.
Okay, man, I want to ask a question now because I used to go to party and they say that if you go to party, you have to do that, you have home training. I'm not about to finish all the food. They give you food, you just leave small in the plate, you know, to judge you that you are a big boy. So are you saying that I'm not supposed to be leaving food inside the plate? Because that is what they have teach us when we are growing up, that I don't leave small in the plate to show that you are a big boy.
Well, because we need to let big boy go and ensure that everybody eats. When you serve food, the proper thing to do is to finish your food. Nobody says you should lick your plates because that would be ridiculous. So we need to look for ways to avoid wastage as much as possible. And one way we can do that is to ensure that we finish our food. So there is no pride actually in having your food remain where you're eating or as much as possible. If you put something in your plate to eat, finish it. And it's even better to get food in bits than to put so much and you can't finish it, even if you're at home. Sometimes you are very hungry and then you scoop so much food and then in less than 3 minutes you see you can't eat again. We need to stop that. So you scoop a little, when you're done, you go get more. That's a better way of managing waste. And then also, we need to work on our budgets. So you ensure that you only buy what you really need. perishable items are have the highest level of waste because they are highly perishable. Things like fruits, vegetables, tubers and roots. So when you are buying these, you need to understand that they are perishable and we shouldn't plan to store them for so long. Not because you went to a place, you saw them cheap, you buy,
so,
stock your home.
Excuse me, I don't want to eat a lot. As you are talking about fruits, I'm looking at this. So that means you are going to eat all these things that you are.
This thing is meant for decoration. Do what you are doing. Leave this one in.
I don't want it to waste. That is why I'm saying. So that we not waste. Because I'm looking at all these fruits now. I'm thinking, this thing cannot waste. Maybe I'll just start, you know, sharing it now.
So that we can share it so that it will go around. You know, we are talking about zero level.
Because that's what I'm thinking. So, okay, so continue. I'll tell you how we can eliminate this wastage. By eating the fruit. So continue.
So we can ensure that whatever we put in our plate, we are finishing it. And then we can ensure we really buy what we need. Another way is to give out to people. We need to learn to do charity. Each time you are eating, remember there's somebody out there who doesn't have food. Do all you can to support and to feed people. I really cannot count how many people in Bombs who's feed for free in a year. But I can tell you clearly, without exaggerating at all, that we feed over 1,000 people every year for free. In different ways, different means. So the same thing with you. You go to a place, you find food cheap, buy them, and then when you buy them, distribute to other people. Give to your neighbors, give to people that you feel cannot afford it. Each time you throw that food into your trash, remember that food would have saved a life. I think that aspect is very important. And then much more than that also, we need to educate our children, our wards, on why they shouldn't waste food. And then we need to look at agriculture a lot. All of us, we need to find a way in our small garden at home, plant something. Find ways to improve the quality and quantity of food we have. When we have enough, the prices will come down and everybody will be able to afford it. So we should look for ways to educate people on the need for us to support each other so that together we can eradicate food wastage. And then also learn more on how you can prevent your food and preserve them so that they can last longer. And then stock only what you need, really. Stock what you need. Don't be greedy. Remember, your neighbor also must have something.
Okay, now that is interesting because honestly, you mean myself, I'm a charitable person. I also ensure that I share food whenever I have the opportunity. I used to remain food for my junior brother. So now I also have something that I have been thinking about. It's bothering me because I used to think. I noticed that when people go to a party, I'm talking about big people that they have plenty of money in their pocket. They are using Range Rover 2020 or something like that. Anyway, they go to a party and they don't give them food, they will not be getting angry and be vexing. I don't understand why. Why is it that people are always vexing when they do not see food, even though they have money? Still be getting angry because they do not give them food. What is the problem?
Well, that's it's their body that is responding naturally. First of all, it has been proven over time that a lot of people go to parties hungry.
Not because
they don't have food at home, but because you already know I'm going to a party, so I don't have to eat at home. There'll be something there to eat. Or at other times they went somewhere before coming here, or they've been at that party for long and then their bodies responded. Because every food you eat, your body processes it and then turns it into amino acid, fats and simple sugars. And these simple sugars in form of glucose. When your body begins to run out of glucose, that's the point where you are hungry. So your body sends an alarm to you that I need more glucose. And when that happens, you become irritable, you become moody. Any little things, your level of tolerance reduces. So any little thing annoys you.
I know I understand English, but I'm thinking some people that are watching there, I know they understand English like that. Maybe you can tell them what irritable thing. Tell me, what is irritable?
Irritable, where I'm talking about any little thing annoys you. Any little thing annoys you. And that happens because these big men and these people you are talking about, almost all the time people go to party hungry. They go to parties hungry. They don't eat before leaving for several reasons. Oh, where I'm going to, there'll be food there. Or maybe they went somewhere before coming here. So sometimes that person comes there already hungry and the person is seeing the food and he's not having it. So at that point, the body system sends an alarm. And that person has become irritable. That person's tolerance level has reduced. And then at that point, person becomes angry, and that's why they say a hungry man is an angry man.
That one is true. Me, I used to wear, so if I go to party, I don't get food.
So we need to ensure everybody at the party gets food.
Things money upon that. I even wear white clothes. I even do Yoruba demon. So you now tell me I will not see food. I will scatter the place. So I think, but I'm just saying that one because you doing your hand, you understand? So that is why you won't think that I'm a rough person. So now, I also want to ask a question because that's another one I have problem with. It's people that used to go to a party and they used to eat more than two times. They will not eat one, two, three, four. Why? I mean, what is the problem? Is it their stomach they want to use and go to Oyo or something like that? No, that's not it.
I don't know what is wrong with them because it's actually very wrong. And if you're here, you used to do this at the party, you eat one, two, three times. It is wrong, go. Please consider others. It's actually wrong. When you've eaten once, you should allow the food go around so other people can have. So if you go for an event, please allow other people eat their own.
That's what I'm saying. But me, I'm not like, sometimes one round is not enough. Maybe there is rice, there is fried rice, there is amala, there is eba. Are you saying that I cannot taste all of them? Because me, I'm interested in everything. So I think maybe I'll just take one rice, one eba, one pandeyam, one semo.
So you're among them?
One malt, one coke.
You're among the people who eat 3-4 times at party.
No, it's not 4 times, just one. I want to know how everything they are having.
So you're like them?
No, I'm not saying that.
You eat more than once at the party?
Only one rice. At least if I eat one rice, one eba, it's two different rules. You can't say now it's two rounds.
Two different food, that's two. You have eaten two different food, that's two rounds.
So I don't eat rice.
No, why you see various options at the party is not so that you consume all. It's so that you make a choice what is most suitable for you at that point.
But I like everything.
You can't possibly like everything.
Yeah, so I like everything.
You look at the one you like most and you eat that one.
So that other people can have rice.
Yes, so that other people can have theirs too.
Okay.
Except for maybe a buffet or something. The food was planned for maybe 400 guests. And then you are eating three times. How many people will have food eventually?
Some people don't use to eat too much anyway. It's okay. People we have here, that is what they say. People should be eating only about rice. It's okay. So, as you are here now, that is the gist anyway. If you are a foodie person, this is what you need to know. You should not be wasting food. Because I see that most of the time, you are always taking about how you are going to eat. You don't take about how you are going to give someone. So, you are going to be a charitable person. So, thank you very much, even on food, because you are actually helpful. So, me, I also ask one last question. Don't look at me, I'm rushing you. Because, you know, food people like you, nah, they don't rush you. So, since you are here now, I want you to tell me something. Is that you got people that are watching so that they will know that you are an expert person? Can you tell me one thing that you know about food that you think will just shock me like this?
Okay, let me tell you one shocking thing about food. Let me see which of them. Something about food that will shock you. Okay, yes. How many of us know that carrots used to be purple in color? Carrots, yes.
That carrot
you're eating that is orange color now used to be purple.
As in color purple?
Especially before the 17th century or so. Carrots used to be purple and then, of course, yellow. Some also have
so
been yellow.
So, who used to eat it?
People, the same people that
will eat purple carrots.
Yes.
Now, fried rice will become I think fried rice will be looking like a black currant or something like that. They'll be calling it black currant rice. They'll be using it for.
Okay, let me even ask you again. This one again. I'm sure this one too will shock you. Do you know that chocolate was once a form of currency? Yes.
That was amazing though.
So the chocolate you are eating now was once
a form of currency. No,
you can
be using
it to pay money.
I didn't know that one before. I know many people did not know that one before. So why are they not using it again?
Well, I don't know. We have a better means of currency now.
I think maybe we should be using chocolate to be paying money.
People will just be eating it so nobody will pay again.
True, you just eat your salary. You don't want to explain it. If you don't give your salary, you finish it before you reach home. Anyway, so that is the end of our interview session.
Wait, Mitra, I want to ask you a question.
Okay, that's what I mean. That is that. It's not by you interview the interviewer.
Have you ever heard? Do you speak like someone in particular, like Nigerian artist?
Do like a dangle thing or something like that. And it's true anyway, because you know we are long distance related. So yeah, just that they tell us that we will not be talking to him because he's a proud person. So that is why. I mean, not as if I'm lying or something. I'm just saying you are distant relative like that. So that is it.
I'm not talking about dangle. Okay, have you ever heard of Faust the Bike?
Who is a Faust? I'm not a bad person. And they are telling me I should not be moving with bad people. So I don't even understand that this is a bad fouling person that you're talking about. Because honestly, I'm not a bad person. I don't know any fouls, what do you call it? I don't even know what a foul is because honestly, I'm not a bad person. So I don't know you're talking about a bad guy. I'm a good person. My mommy trained me very well. So I think maybe that is the problem. I'm a good guy. Everybody used to look at me and say, this boy, you're a good person.
So what's your own name?
Me, I'm Borda Danel.
Borda Danel.
Yes, honestly. So I mean Borda Danel. It's not a bro. I'm just a Borda Danel.
Borda Danel is not Borda Danel, but
I'm a brother Daniel. So that is me. So thank you very much for coming. Honestly, that is the whole question that you have, Abby. So thank you very much. So you have learned now. This is World Food Day. I am celebrating World Food Day. So if you have been waiting for food, you have to go and change your habit. Or we'll come and look for you and beat you. I'll come with her, honestly. We'll come with Ibon soup. I'll come and beat all of you. And those of you that used to eat 2 times, 3 times when you go to party, is it your stomach they want to use and go to Oyoni? Why exactly is the problem? Is it that you do not eat before you leave the house, or when you finish eating at the party, you don't eat again? That is what they are telling you now. So in case maybe you are taking, you want to go to the party and you want to take more than one time, I don't know where I carry your stomach can be going to. Yeah? But if you are just eat only once and forget about the rest. You have heard it from the food expert, they have tell you everything that you need to understand, to push you there, to let you understand that food is wasting and you are wasting the food. If you go to a party and you eat the food, you can even use your hand to kind of like circle the whole thing to make sure that everything is clear. You can watch it. So that they won't have to say that you are waiting for or something like that. I do love it. I used to go to party with nylon bag. I don't know what your mission in life is. I don't know what you are trying to accomplish. Maybe after that party, you'll not eat again for the rest of your life or something like that. I do love it. I used to keep me inside tissue paper. I don't know what you are finding for. That you cannot just eat food and leave everything there. You will put it inside tissue paper. I don't know. But that you have heard the word now. So don't go out today and be wasting food or come and be doing food that you are not used to go out. If you also go out, you will know what we are talking about. People like, oh, you are exposed. You understand what I'm saying? So thank you very much for everything I'm saying. Thank you very much, even so for actually honoring our invitation and coming out. So maybe you cut this in the joint so that we can digest this apple that is here in our front. It's okay, you can go now.